Hey guys, Kevin here, and in this video, we're gonna talk about probably the most important technique and application for self-defense, and that is awareness. We're gonna talk about awareness. Awareness of your surroundings, awareness while you're out in public, walking in the street, in buildings like restaurants or bars. And by the end of this video, you're gonna have a very solid understanding of things that you should be keeping in mind and things you should be doing to ensure your personal safety. Okay, awareness. When I'm talking about awareness, there's three key parts to awareness that I want to discuss. First one is in public, while you're walking down the street. The second one is while you're in buildings, bars, restaurants, things that you need to keep in mind, things that you should do to try to maximize your safety and maximize your awareness. And third is your self-awareness. Let's start with awareness in public on the street. Okay, I got my notes here. I wanna make sure I don't miss anything. But first thing that we're gonna talk about is awareness on the street. And the very first thing is walking with purpose. There have been studies done, interviews done with rapists and other criminals in jail, and they state that they choose their victims. They scout them out and they pick them out based on, you know, how they carry themselves. If they appear to be a challenge, if they're gonna be putting up a fight or a struggle, how easy of a target they are. So how you carry yourself in public is extremely important. Number one, you need to stand tall. You need to be aware. Stay off your phone. Same thing when they talk about no texting and driving. You shouldn't be walking down the street in public with your face buried in your phone either, just texting away, not aware of what's going on around you. You know, if you get a message or something, fine, stop, go off to the side of the sidewalk, answer it, and put it back in your pocket or purse and keep on walking. It should be the same thing. You shouldn't be walking down the street in public or out amongst people or anywhere with your face buried in your phone. You need to be aware of the people around you, the vehicles around you. You need to be aware of sounds. You want to be able to hear. You don't want to just have your phone and your earbuds in or your headphones on with music blaring so that you're not hearing footsteps that come up from behind you or a car approaching. You want to be totally aware while you're in public. Okay, so walk with purpose. You want to walk upright. You want to be looking around. You want to look confident. Even if you don't feel confident, walk with your head up. Don't be looking down, walking, kind of dragging your feet and staring at the ground. Keep an eye on the people passing you, approaching you, standing on the streets, all of these things. You should be paying attention. When you do pass somebody, if somebody's coming towards you on the street and you look and you're walking past them, don't look down. Okay, if somebody's coming at you, don't look down, look them in the eye. You can say good morning or hello if you want, but at least make eye contact or look directly at them in the eye. Even if they don't return the glance, be sure that you look at each individual that walks by. Because if anybody is walking towards you and has any ill intent, you looking at them triggers in their mind that they've been seen, okay? They've been seen, they can be identified from that point, and it may just change their mind from what they're gonna plan on doing. You don't know. But victims, you don't wanna walk the street looking like a victim. You don't wanna have your head down, walking totally oblivious to what's going on. Okay, another thing is when you're coming up to a corner and you're walking around the corner of the building, you don't wanna cut your corners sharp because you don't wanna end up walking right along the wall and then taking a sharp turn and have somebody be standing there. You wanna come up to a corner of a building, you wanna walk to the outside so that as you're coming around the corner, you're already seeing around the corner before you start taking the corner. If you understand what I'm saying. If you're walking down the street and you have a corner, you don't wanna come right up to the corner and make a sharp turn and have somebody be standing there. You want to be moved to the outside of the sidewalk, take a wider turn on that corner so that you can start seeing around the corner as you are coming around the corner. So that way you're able to see. Same thing when you come up to a blind doorway, because some doorways are set back into the building. You want same thing. You don't want to walk straight along the really close up to the building and approach the doorway or pass a doorway coming right up against it. You want to walk to the outside, okay, and be able to look at that doorway and glance and look inside as you're approaching it and keep an eye on it to make sure that this doorway is safe, that nobody's in there kind of creeping around or waiting for you, all right? You want to be able to see as much as possible, taking your corners, taking doorways. You want to be safe, especially at night, especially if you're out. And lastly, when you're in public, trust your gut. So many people that have been in accidents or have been attacked have mentioned that, you know, I felt something was wrong and I did it anyway, or, you know, I should have listened to my gut. I knew I shouldn't have went in there. They ignore it and things happen. Trust your gut. You have that sense in you, that intuition, whether it's the Holy Spirit that's telling you to do something, whether it's your subconscious, whatever it is, trust it. It's there for a reason. It goes off for a reason. If you're walking and you see a group of people standing on the street and you get a sick feeling or a, you know, ill feeling in your stomach, that, hey, you know, these people don't look right, you know, this group looks like they're up to no good, you either need to turn around and walk the other way, cross the street, whatever, but trust your gut. Next, we're going to talk about awareness in buildings, in bars, when you're in a building. The biggest thing when I'm in a building is I do not sit with my back to the door. Whether you're standing in line at a bank, whether you are sitting in a restaurant, you want to be able to observe the entrance and keep an eye on the people that are coming in. I sit normally, if I'm in a restaurant, I sit with my back to a wall so that I can see the door. If for any reason I can't, I at least sit somewhere facing the door. If there's other tables behind me, I've already looked when I get taken to the table to be seated. I've already looked around me. I looked at the people that are sitting around me. I sit down, but I still keep an eye on the door. And I'm not saying to be paranoid. When somebody comes into the restaurant or into the club, if you can see, just kind of look, you know, give a quick look, take a quick scan to see if anything looks out of place or suspicious, if somebody's acting suspicious. And, you know, then just go about whatever you're doing, but pay attention. You know, don't just sit there and, you know, be totally oblivious of what's going on. Number two, when you come into a building, a restaurant, a store, whatever, note where the exits are. Because it doesn't have to be a shooting or some crazed person. It could just be something like a fire. You want to know where the exits are. You know, that's your personal safety. So when you walk in, you kind of look, you scan, you look for the exit signs, you kind of make a mental note really quick where they are. And, you know, so that you're familiar with where they are, where if, Lord forbid, something does happen, you know, at least have an idea, you know where to head, where to go, where to run to get out of there. And then when you leave the building and you're going to your car, not only if you're walking down the street, just like the last time, you want to pay attention to people walking around. But if you're going to your car, especially at night, give the parking lot a scan before you head to your car. Take note if there's any cars that look suspicious parked around your car. If anybody's just kind of standing outside their car and looking kind of out of place near your car before you head there. Because especially here in Tampa, Florida, there is a huge sexual trafficking and human trafficking rings down here. And people are abducted and taken for that very purpose. And some of these people are very brazen and bold and will do it in broad daylight. They pull up a vehicle, snatch you, and they're gone. You know, these kind of things happen in real life. It's not just in the movies. It happens right here and everywhere in this country. So when you're going to your vehicle, make a quick scan of the parking lot, take note of where your vehicle is. If you don't remember or the parking lot's full, use that key fob and set your alarm off. You know, not only to locate your vehicle, but also once you hear it, look in the direction, see if anybody's running or leaving that area or looks out of place. You know, you want to take note of these things, especially if you're out late at night and especially if it's dark. If you feel uncomfortable and somebody looks like they're out of place, somebody looks suspicious, or you don't feel safe going to your vehicle, ask for an escort, you know, from somebody inside. See if a worker in the store can walk you to your vehicle. Sometimes some police departments, if you really feel that something is out of place, some police departments do and will send an officer over there to check things out and make sure that there's nothing out of place. But be sure that you scan the parking lot before heading to your vehicle and make sure that your keys are in hand before you get to your car. Don't stand at your vehicle fumbling for your keys. Be ready with your keys to get into your vehicle as soon as you show up. And lastly, with awareness is self-awareness. Now, self-awareness can go really deep, but all we're really talking about as it pertains to self-defense is knowing your weaknesses, both physical, emotional. You know, you have to know what your weaknesses are. If something were to happen on the street or if in a club or whatever, are you able to run? Are you able to run and escape that danger? If you're like me and have bad knees or you have some kind of ailment or limitation or an injury and you can't run, you got to know that, because if something happens and I can't run, then what am I going to do? You know, so you got to know what you're able to do and be aware of your weaknesses, both physical. If you're high anxiety, if you suffer from anxiety and you're all of a sudden something like that happens, all of a sudden your stress level is through the roof. Are you going to be able to think clearly and handle that situation if it arises? These are things you have to know ahead of time. You have to be aware of your weaknesses and maybe, you know, things that may come up that might prevent you from getting out of there and being safe. Along with that is not only knowing what you're capable of doing and what you are able to do, it's also what are you willing to do. If whether you take self-defense classes or not, whether you study a martial art or not, whether you read a self-defense book, whatever, there's tons of videos, not just the ones I produce, there's tons of videos online and on YouTube on self-defense. But you have to ask yourself, what are you going to be willing to do to survive and return home safely to your family? If it comes right down to it, are you going to be able to gouge somebody's eyes and possibly blind them for life? Or maybe slap their ears and deafen them for life? You know, I mean, are you going to be able to do things that may physically maim somebody permanently or even possibly kill them? Are you willing to go that far? You have to know, because I have taught self-defense classes and self-defense seminars, and I've taught some movements that gouge eyes or strike a throat or, you know, are hitting very sensitive parts of the body. And some of the people are very uncomfortable with that. They think it's overkill. You've got to know if you are one of those people. Do you think that's too much? Is that going too far to ensure that you go home to your loved ones? Because an attacker, somebody like Bob here, that doesn't care if you've got family at home, doesn't have the slightest care in the world about your well-being or safety, and is only intent on satisfying whatever need or greed that he has, they're not going to care. And it's going to be up to you to stop them and stop them from attacking and escape. And you've got to know what you're willing to do to pull that off. You have to be aware of how far you're willing to go. If you're willing to do what it takes to stop that attack, escape, and get to safety. And I know this sounds like being, it sounds like it's being paranoid, but it's really not. These are all just small things. You don't do them all at one time. You're not just standing really straight and walking down and scanning everything constantly and everything else. You're not doing all this. It's done very naturally. It's done in a matter of seconds. Once you become more and more aware of these things and start putting them into practice, they become natural. You don't even think about doing it. You're going to walk into a McDonald's or sit down at a McDonald's, get your food, go take a seat, and you're automatically just going to sit with your back facing the wall so that you can see an entrance. So you might sit in a corner where you can scan the whole restaurant. It's just automatically just going to happen because you do it over and over again. You want to make these things a habit. Same thing when you're walking down the street. You're just automatically going to take wider corners and approach doorways from a wider angle so that you can see into the doorway before you get to it or as you're coming up to it. So these are all things that come about naturally through practice. It's not being paranoid. The only person that's responsible for your personal safety is you. You cannot rely on the police. You cannot rely on the government. You cannot rely on security at a nightclub. You have to rely on you, because by the time any of those people get involved, it's too late. It's too late. Unless a police officer just happens to be standing very close by and sees something about to happen and interferes and stops it, they're going to get called and show up after the fact, after the attack has already happened, after the damage is done. That's when all these things happen. So the only person that's responsible for your safety, whether you're at home, whether you're out in public, whether you are walking down the street, is you. Now, we didn't even get into home safety as far as being, you know, improving the safety in your home or anything like that. That can be another video. Right now, we're just talking about your awareness, staying aware of your surroundings, the people around you, the places you're at, all of these things. That's the key to this video. So let's recap. Remember, if you're walking down the street, you want to take wide berths, you want to take wide turns on corners and approaching doorways so that you can see around the corner or into doorways as you're approaching them, not come and cut them short and have somebody be standing there and take you by surprise. Two, you want to walk with purpose and confidence. If you're constantly walking, looking at your phone, put your phone away. Take your headphones out so you can see and hear everything going on around you and scan and watch the people and places and vehicles and things going on around you while you're walking down the street. If you're in a building, you want to sit so that you can see the entrance. See the entrance, take note of the people that are coming in, notice if anybody looks out of place, and then just go about your dinner or whatever it is you're doing. But at least kind of keep an eye out and give a quick scan around the room periodically and keep an eye on who's coming in the building and if anything looks out of place. Also, you want to try to sit with your back to a wall if you can so that you know that nobody's going to come up behind you. If not, when you go to your table and you're about to be seated, take note of the people that are sitting behind you, all right? Kind of give them a quick glance. You know what they look like. You know who's sitting there, and still sit so you can look at the entrance. Also, take note of the exits in the building, whether it's a store or whatever. Walk in, just kind of give a quick glance as you're walking around and take note of where the exits are. Look for those exit signs. You want to know not just if like a shooter or something happens, but whether it's a fire or some other kind of emergency, you want to know where the exit is so that you can get there as quickly as possible. When you leave a building, whether you leave a club, especially if you're alone, especially if it's at night, before you head to your car, scan the parking lot, take a look in the area where your car is, look for anybody standing near your car that doesn't look, normal, looks out of place, looks suspicious. Take note of people that are vehicles that are parked near your car with somebody sitting in it. You know, especially if it's doorway, if it's driver's door to driver's door, because people normally don't park that way. So, you know, take note of these things and be cautious. Have your keys in hand as soon as you get to your door, or even beep your horn or set that alarm off on your car before you approach it. just to make sure that anybody standing around takes notice and possibly leaves. And lastly is self-awareness. Be conscious of your weaknesses, your limitations, whether you can run if something were to happen, if you're able to run, if you're able to hit or kick or fight or whatever. You need to know what your physical limitations are. If you are out of shape and you need to get fit, that's something you need to work on. You want to be fit to fight. Also, you want to know what you are willing to do. Are you willing to do what it takes to stop an attacker and return safely home to your loved ones? Are you going to be willing to gouge somebody's eyes, possibly blind, deafen, or maim them to save your life? You have to know these things. Self-awareness, being aware of what you are able to do and what you are capable to do and what you are willing to do. So that wraps up awareness. And those are the keys that I want to put out there as far as awareness and how it applies to self-defense. Yes, there's probably some more things. If you have anything else that you wish to add, please give a comment below. If you enjoyed this video and you think that other people may benefit as well, give it a thumbs up. Be sure to share and also subscribe so that you get all the upcoming videos and self-defense tips and fitness tips to get fit to fight as well. Also, check out my website at kevinwpatella.com and subscribe there so that anytime a blog article or a new video comes out, you will be notified as soon as it comes out. So until next time, and in the next upcoming videos, we'll talk about self-defense striking, wrist locks, and a bunch of other great stuff. So stay tuned. God bless and be safe.